and I have turned into a zombie.
Halloween is a festival day that takes place on the 31st of October every year. The word Halloween comes from All Hallows' Evening and is the day before All Saints' Day for Christian people. There are all sorts of ways to celebrate Halloween: carving pumpkins, trick-or-treating, dressing up and going to parties, and visiting spooky places. For me, it's a good excuse to talk about some scary movies. I want to introduce five scary movies to you. Scary children's movies. I promise they are not too scary. In fact, most of them are creepy rather than scary. What's the difference between creepy and scary? Let's say that scary is when you jump, and creepy is when you shiver. Ooh. Coraline is about a young girl called Coraline who finds a secret door in her new home. On the other side is another version of her home that is a bit happier, a bit brighter, and a bit more fun than her actual home. But everyone has buttons for eyes.
You're just in time for supper, dear.
You're not my mother. My mother doesn't have...
Buttons? Do you like them? I'm your other mother, silly.
And they want Coraline to change her eyes to buttons, too. This is a very creepy movie, but not too scary. Definitely a good one to watch with your grown-ups on Halloween. Goosebumps is about three teenagers who accidentally unlock all of the monsters from the Goosebumps books. The monsters literally come off the page. They are chased by a yeti, a werewolf, a scary clown, an invisible boy.
It's the invisible boy!
Ow! A giant insect, and even some garden gnomes.
Maybe they're friendly. Not friendly.
This is the opposite of Coraline. Not really creepy, but quite scary. Next is Labyrinth. I watched this many times when I was young, and it is amazing, if a little creepy at times. Sarah is babysitting her little brother, but she becomes so angry with him crying that she wishes someone would take him away. And the Goblin King does exactly that. Sarah must get through a labyrinth, which is a maze, to rescue her baby brother. She meets many, many strange creatures and unexpected events along the way. This film is a U in Britain, which is like Category 1 in Hong Kong. It's only a little bit scary and a little bit creepy, but overall, a good adventure movie. Similarly, The Neverending Story is from the 80s when I was young. It's about a boy who reads a book called The Neverending Story. He finds that the characters in the book know he is reading it, and the events are starting to be real events. This is another adventure movie, but some parts are definitely quite scary. Even though it says suitable for children in Britain, I definitely watch it with your grown-ups the first time. Scarier and creepier than Labyrinth. Finally, The Witches.
The Witches.
I watched this when I was young, and it is definitely quite a scary movie. It is about a boy who accidentally sees a meeting of witches in a hotel, and then gets turned into a mouse. For the most part, it's a fun adventure as the mouse tries to defeat the witches. The most frightening part is when the Grand High Witch takes off her mask. I'm not even going to show you that part, but here it is in the book. Now imagine that in the movie. Actually, All of these movies are books too. So if you like them, or you want to read them first, then go to your local library or search the catalogue online. I especially recommend Roald Dahl, who wrote many brilliant books for young people, and who would have been 100 years old this year. There are lots of fun things to see and read and play on the Roald Dahl website, so check that out too. Have a happy Halloween, and don't have bad dreams.
It's Halloween, and I have turned into a zombie.
Halloween is a festival day that takes place on the 31st of October every year. The word Halloween comes from All Hallows' Evening and is the day before All Saints' Day for Christian people. There are all sorts of ways to celebrate Halloween: carving pumpkins, trick-or-treating, dressing up and going to parties, and visiting spooky places. For me, it's a good excuse to talk about some scary movies. I want to introduce 5 scary movies to you. Scary children's movies. I promise they are not too scary. In fact, most of them are creepy rather than scary. What's the difference between creepy and scary? Let's say that scary is when you jump, and creepy is when you shiver. Ooh. Coraline is about a young girl called Coraline who finds a secret door in her new home. On the other side is another version of her home that is a bit happier, a bit brighter, and a bit more fun than her actual home. But everyone has buttons for eyes.
You're just in time for supper, dear.
You're not my mother. My mother doesn't have...
Buttons? Do you like them? I'm your other mother, silly.
And they want Coraline to change her eyes to buttons, too. This is a very creepy movie, but not too scary. Definitely a good one to watch with your grown-ups on Halloween. Goosebumps is about 3 teenagers who accidentally unlock all of the monsters from the Goosebumps books. The monsters literally come off the page. They are chased by a yeti, a werewolf, a scary clown, an invisible boy.
What was that?
It's the invisible boy.
Ow!
A giant insect, and even some garden gnomes.
Maybe they're friendly.
Not friendly.
This is the opposite of Coraline. Not really creepy, but quite scary. Next is Labyrinth. I watched this many times when I was young, and it is amazing, if a little creepy at times. Sarah is babysitting her little brother, but she becomes so angry with him crying that she wishes someone would take him away. And the Goblin King does exactly that. Sarah must get through a labyrinth, which is a maze, to rescue her baby brother. She meets many, many strange creatures and unexpected events along the way. This film is a U in Britain, which is like Category 1 in Hong Kong. It's only a little bit scary and a little bit creepy, but overall, a good adventure movie. Similarly, The Neverending Story is from the 80s when I was young. It's about a boy who reads a book called The Neverending Story. He finds that the characters in the book know he is reading it, and the events are starting to be real events. This is another adventure movie, but some parts are definitely quite scary. Even though it says suitable for children in Britain, I definitely watch it with your grown-ups the first time. Scarier and creepier than Labyrinth. Finally, The Witches.
The Witches.
I watched this when I was young, and it is definitely quite a scary movie. It is about a boy who accidentally sees a meeting of witches in a hotel, and then gets turned into a mouse. For the most part, it's a fun adventure as the mouse tries to defeat the witches. The most frightening part is when the Grand High Witch takes off her mask. I'm not even going to show you that part, but here it is in the book. Now imagine that in the movie. Actually, all of these movies are books too, so if you like them, or you want to read them first, then go to your local library or search the catalogue online. I especially recommend Roald Dahl, who wrote many brilliant books for young people and who would have been 100 years old this year. There are lots of fun things to see and read and play on the Roald Dahl website, so check that out too. Have a happy Halloween and don't have bad dreams.
Thank you.